Hi everyone. In this session, we will discuss about aneroid barometer. In last session, we studied about simple barometer and Fortean barometer. And we studied that both barometer has liquid. So if you see this aneroid barometer, it doesn't have any liquid. It's very lightweight. So it's easy to carry from one place to another place. And moreover, we can easily calibrate the reading of the atmospheric pressure directly. Let's see the parts of aneroid barometer. Okay, so aneroid barometer have a metallic portion at the bottom, which is considered this as B, and on the top it is covered with a diaphragm like material. Okay, so diaphragm means you know that it is pressable. And inside portion it is somewhat evacuated, not completely, but halfly it is evacuated. Consider this is D. And on the top of this diaphragm, we have arranged a load or a rod, an iron rod with the top part is toothed one. Okay. So here we have a rod L and the top of that load is toothed one. Okay. It's like this way. So this is the way how the load is. Okay. And we have a wheel, tooth wheel connected very perfectly with this teeth of this load. Okay. So this is also connected in the same manner. It has to be fixed. It's a wheel. A round tooth wheel is arranged like this way. Okay, and from this wheel we have a pointer, and here we have a round marking or reading. Okay, so here we have a round marking or reading, and here we have the pointer is connected with this wheel. Okay, this is the setup of an aneroid barometer. Down part one diaphragm, along with the diaphragm we connected a tooth wheel and tooth rod, and that is connected with another tooth wheel with a pointer. The circular scale is marked with 75 76 77 78, like that. Okay, let's see how it works. So, I already told you that this is a diaphragm. Okay. So, when the atmospheric pressure increases, the pressure acts on this diaphragm and it goes inward. So, by that time, the rod is also attached with this one. So, it presses down. By that time, the pointer which is connected along with the wheel will move towards the right side. So, if the pressure increases, it moves towards the right side. So, from the scale directly we can calibrate the reading. Now, if the pressure getting reduced, what happens? This diaphragm will bulge outward. So, by that way, during that time, directly it's connected with the rod and the wheel. So, the pointer will move towards the left side. So, by seeing the reading where the pointer is placed, we can directly calibrate the atmospheric pressure, and it's very easy to carry. It doesn't have any liquid, so we don't want to give much care to carry this aneroid barometer from one place to another place. Let's see the uses of this barometer. Mainly, this aneroid barometer is used for three purposes. First one, to measure the atmospheric pressure. Second one, we are using this aneroid barometer for weather forecasting. Okay, we are using this for weather forecasting. And third one, we are using this aneroid barometer as altimeter. So these are the main three uses of aneroid barometer. We will see this in detail. Okay, the first use of aneroid barometer is to measure the atmospheric pressure. Okay, so we know that as the altitude changes, the atmospheric pressure varies. Okay, So first case, as the atmosphere or the altitude decreases, what happen to the air column? The height of the air column decreases, or the thrust acting on the surface is getting decreased. So as the thrust decreases, automatically the atmospheric pressure decreases. But height of the air column and the atmospheric pressure variation is always in a linear manner. Okay, the atmospheric pressure will decrease in a linear way as the height of the column decreases. And this atmospheric pressure is related with the density of the air. Okay, so we know that the air, the down layer or the sea level air is completely compressed with the air particle, right? No, because the weight is acting on the downward layers. So automatically the layer which is very close near to the air, sea level, is more compressed, and the density of that air level is more comparing with the top layers. Okay, so as it goes upward, the density decreases and automatically the atmospheric pressure also decreases. But that variation with the density is not always linear. Near to the sea level, it shows a rapid variation, and when it goes to high altitude, the variation, the atmospheric and density variations are very slow variation it shows. That's why it's not linear. If always it shows a correct variation, we'll get a straight line. Okay, but it never shows according to this way. Non-linear means it shows a graph like this way. Okay, so the density variation and atmospheric pressure shows a non-linear variation, and the height of the air column with atmospheric pressure, it's always linear. So based on these two factors, we can measure the atmospheric pressure with the help of anaerobic barometer. So the pressure exerting on the diaphragm will vary. It calibrates the corresponding value. That is the first use. Weather forecast is mainly based on the density of the air. How the density varies, it affects the atmospheric pressure. Okay. So the temperature and the presence of moisture content is a factor which affect the weather in a particular area. Okay. So we know that as the temperature increases, what happens to density? The density decreases. Same way, as the moisture content in the atmosphere increases, automatically the density decreases. So if we compare the density of dry air and moisture air, the moisture air has less density compared with the dry air. Okay, so based on these two, temperature and the moisture content, we used to use this anaerobic barometer for weather forecasting. See how we forecast the weather. So first one, just consider that the barometric height suddenly falls. Okay, or the reading of the barometer suddenly falls. First one, it suddenly falls. If the barometric height suddenly falls, means it shows the pressure suddenly fall down. It is an indication for cyclone or storm. Okay, if the barometric height or the reading is suddenly false, it is a indication for coming up of a cyclone or a storm. Okay, the next one, if it gradually falls, what happens? If the height or the reading gradually falls, it shows a presence of more moisture content in the air. Okay, gradually falls means it shows the presence of more moisture content in the atmosphere, and that is the indication for a rainfall. Okay, if moisture content is there, that means more water droplets are available in the atmosphere. It's a chance for getting rain. Okay, third one, if there is a gradual rise in the reading. Okay, if there is a gradual rise in the reading, it shows that the moisture content is reducing in the atmosphere, and it shows a dry weather. Okay, it shows a dry weather. fourth one, sudden raise in the reading. Okay, so suddenly the pressure is increasing means it shows that suddenly the air is moving from high pressure area to low pressure area, and it's an indication for extremely dry weather. Okay, it's an indication for extremely dry weather. Then our last condition, if there is no much variation in the reading, okay, no variation, it shows a normal weather. Okay, it shows a normal weather. So on the basis of how the readings are varying, this is the way how we use to forecast the weather. If there is a sudden fall in the barometric height or reading, it is an indication for cyclone or heavy storm. Then gradual falls means moisture content will be more in the atmosphere. It is an indication for rainfall. Then gradual rise is an indication for dry weather. Sudden rise, extremely dry weather. No much variation means it shows a normal weather. Let's see the last. Altimeter is also an erode barometer, but actually this is used by in the aircraft. Okay, this is used in the aircraft to understand the height above the sea level, because we know that as the height of the air column decreases, it shows a pressure variation. So what happens to the reading? If it is at a high altitude, it shows less pressure, or it moves towards the left side. If it is near to the sea level, it moves towards the right side. So atmospheric pressure will be more. So on the basis of the indication towards left and right side, we can easily calibrate the height from the sea level. So it is used in the aircraft to understand the height or altitude from the ground. So these are the different uses of an erode barometer in our day-to-day life. Thank you.